He's all cleaned up. It's a new Steve-O. Comedy special to get to. Chuck Liddell was here the other day talking about this unbelievable thing in Peru. Steve on the exact same trip. Is it fair to say it's a new you? No more tattoos on your hands?
Well,
we used to have to cover them with makeup because they said dirty things.
Oh, right. Right.
Uh-huh. Right. Yeah, 4-letter words on each hand. Is it a new me? I suppose. I'm a work in progress.
All right. And, yeah. And working very successfully as a stand-up comic.
That's right. I've been on tour for 7 years. I'm taping my second comedy special this Saturday.
And you were saying that because of all the stuff on Jackass and everything, stuff that you make jokes. You know, remember when that guy was hitting me in the head with a baseball bat? You have tape of the guy hitting you in the head with a baseball
sure.
bat.
Sure. So it's a part Jackass, maybe part comedy special, all married together with footage edited into the stand-up and a bunch of new vignettes and featuring the entire cast of Jackass.
Wow. And I know there has been, I don't know, legal stuff or whatever. Why hasn't an actual official Jackass movie come? Because not everybody wants to do it, or what would...
Knoxville would rather people ask for another movie than why'd you make that last one?
Okay.
He's protective of the legacy.
The legacy, so, as it were.
But would you, the new Steve-O, be as daring?
Oh, yeah. I've been getting even crazier.
Really?
Oh. And that's what's so great about this new one is that I self-funded everything so I could, you know, go ride to the theater down the highway, duct taped to the side of the truck. That's the opening sequence. Like, I mean, you could never insure the stuff I do.
No, you
yes,
can't.
You can't.
Ever.
Or want to.
Yeah. And I'm on probation still. And it's crazy how I got away. I'm so lucky that I got away with all the things I did.
Yes.
Wow, don't say that, because they're going to arrest you live
yeah.
on
yeah.
the air.
I'm going to look into it
no,
again.
No, I'm sure
yeah.
everything you've done is fine.
Everything's perfect.
Right.
Admitting you're guilty
right.
on the case.
Don't quite.
That's the craziest
right.
thing you've
well,
done.
I mean, I think that probably lands in a legal gray area.
Okay.
All right. No gray area here. Big billboard on Sunset. I saw this morning. Ultimate Expedition. You, Chuck Liddell, a bunch of people. This mountain in Peru.
Right.
On one level, sounds like the greatest thing ever. On another level, and I'm the coward of all time. I would never.
No, you're not, Sam.
I kind of am. But anyway, go ahead. Did you have fun?
It was, I mean, it was sort of it was guaranteed everyone's gonna reach like a breaking point and just melt down and I can't handle it. It was terrifying. It was also just beautiful. For me, like going into it, the biggest challenge was not having cell phone service, I think. That, you know.
Chuck told us he actually appreciated that he liked that.
Okay.
Good for you.
The most beautiful thing for me was that I knew we were gonna spend close to 3 weeks at this base camp up in the mountains, and there were street dogs everywhere. So I decided, oh, let me get a couple bags of dog food. I'll feed dogs. Maybe I find one I can bring up to base camp. And
is that a bad idea?
Oh, no. I found the most wonderful dog. And we had 5 days in the hotel. I slept with her outside because they wouldn't let her in the hotel.
Oh,
so the first 5 days of the trip, I was in a tent with this beautiful street dog named Wendy. And we brought her up to base camp. I just fell in love with her so much. Now I brought her home.
You did.
Oh,
so now you have a new dog.
Talk about the ultimate rescue.
Yeah. Oh, she's the best. And now she's a Belgian Malinois, which is like the kind that they use for canine, you know, and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. She's super trainable. So she's with the top dog trainers in the world and becoming a service dog.
Wow.
Oh, really?
And so it brings you to a tough decision.
You let her go.
Why, no, I'm going to, like, if she's this amazing trained dog and she can help people, then I'm selfish to keep her. But we worked it out. She's going to become a teacher. So when they have a new school come in, she's going to, so I'll part with her for a couple weeks at a time whenever they get a new batch in.
What a story. That's a show right there.
There you go.
I love it.
And a girlfriend for more than a year.
That's right.
How did that happen?
I don't know. I guess I guess sex addict rehab paid off.
I'll tell you what, I can't even keep count. How many of you've done every possible reality show there is?
No. I mean, I did do Dancing with the Stars when I got out of rehab for drugs. And I've done some in like the UK.
That we don't want to talk about? Or,
Well, I mean, it's not that. It's just, but just Dancing with the Stars in this one.
All right. And then with Lux, is that somebody in, would we know her or not?
Yeah, she's not a celebrity, but she does work in production, which is great because she's helped me with with my crazy projects.
Yeah. When you duct tape yourself to the side of a truck, what does she think? She goes, Steve. Yeah, out to work again.
She was telling Knoxville, because he was smashing baseballs at my head, like real baseballs, and hitting him so hard. She's just telling him, you're done. And she's begging him to stop, but he wouldn't stop.
First season of Ultimate Expedition.
She sounds like a keeper, Steve. Yeah. Yeah.
It's on YouTube.
Right? Right?
That's how you know you.
Yeah. It's love.
It's everywhere.
It's love.
9 a.m. YouTube Red for all things Steve-O. Nice to see you.
Hey, always. Thanks. Thank you guys.
Thank you, Steve-O. It's good to see you.
I broke the law.